Thank you, Shauri ji, for the brilliant exposition of the manners afflicting a country. We'll have 15 minutes for questions. Our volunteers are going round. They will be giving you the chicks. You can write the question and contributions. 39,000 of them. All of them are associated with the Christian missionaries, like world religions. In the year 2010-11, they got 10,500 crores of rupees through legitimate means, double that through illegitimate means. Andhra Pradesh is having 75,000 pastors, 650 crores of rupees per year. They are distributing for gaining market share of the religions. West Bengal celebrated the 75th anniversary of the formation of the legislature. They have said they have made 2,232 laws. 2,232 laws in 75 years, and before that the British made so many thousands of laws. So with all these laws, none of them being implemented, yet we'll make a law. When the statues and Tangban were broken, nobody spoke. Ambedkar's statue was broken in Amalapuram. The minister goes and says, I will make a law. Nobody shall break statues. He will make a law now that nobody will break statues. The Maoist People's Guerrilla Army celebrated the second anniversary of the victory of the People's Guerrilla War on the Indian government forces at Chintoor in the year 2010. Wonderful fact. Delhi had a population of 50,000 Muslims in 1951. Now there are 15 lakhs. From 50,000 to 15 lakhs. And all of them are going to enter the National Population Register and so on. Here in Andhra Pradesh, the Chief Minister says, you fellows, you did not elect me, I am appointed. What should I answer you? All political parties, questions please, all political parties, sir, are not only privatized, they are proprietorized. And therefore we are now having not MPs, but HMPs. Hereditary MDs. Rahul Gandhi is sixth generation hereditary MD. Some of the parties, 100% of the MPs are HMDs. RLD was Rashtriya Lokdal of Ajit Singh, 100% of the, some 8 MPs are there. All 8 are children of former MPs. Now, there is no high commander, there is I command. And there are proprietors for the regional parties. Every regional party has got a proprietor. If you take Mulayam Singh, he is a proprietor of one party, they elect the other party, Chandrababu Naidu is another party. Everybody has got one party, he is a proprietor of that party. It is not privatization, it is pluralization. Pluralization of the Indian democracy, that is what is happening. Rajendra Prasad said, ours is one of the best constitutions, but this constitution is not going to help us. If we are going to help elect people without character, even the best constitution cannot achieve all the objectives that we have put in the preamble. That Rajendra Prasad made in the last speech that he made. Friends, in February 2006, Rajasekhar Reddy said, mine is a government of minorities. Mine is a government of minorities. Roshaya said, mine is a government of Dalits. Chandrababu says, mine is a government of BCs. He is going to come out with a minority declaration, like the Lahore declaration. He says, I will give representation on the basis of population for the minorities. This is what was abolished in the constitution. The great constitution abolished the reservations on the basis of religion. That was the constitution. Uncaste. Now they are saying by caste. I give reservations by caste, by religion. Is this integration or disintegration? The I commands. Now one chief minister of West Bengal can say, no, this law shall not be made. Last days of the Mughal. There was a Mughal. There was a central government. The Nizam came here and said, I am the government, I am the state. Now every chief minister he purchased by a package. We are given 10 packages to jail in Kashmir. 10 packages amounting to 100,000 crores of rupees. There it go. Now, the UP government is now given a package of 40,000 crores. Mamata Banerjee is asking for a package of 200,000 crores, otherwise they will pull down this government. So every satrap, every regional satrap, he will be asking packages. In previous Rajabharat's time, it is only suitcase. But now it is packing cases. Money must be given in packing cases. Now, 2 years ago we said, question is this, 70 lakh crores of black money is there in Swiss banks. The great president of India now and finance minister a few days ago, he said there are only 10,000 crores. In 2 years, he has given chance for 772 Indians to convert that black money into white money. How can this continue? And if this money is not sufficient, we have got Pakistan to give us fake currency, which is made in gold city. That fake visas, fake passports, fake B.Tech degrees, all are manufactured in the old city of Hyderabad. Now, how can this country hold together? This is what Dr. Ambedkar said. His peers are coming through now. As responsible citizens, will every one of us stand up? Shall we go on saying like Bhishma in that Kuru Sabha, saying, I don't know Dharma, that man, Yudhishthira is Dharma Raja, you ask him what Dharma is. Are we going to say that? Sir, here are a few questions. Any Urdu? The earth, there are earthquakes of scandals and tsunamis of shame. But why is the UPA2 government is still not shaken enough to fall?
Before I answer that question, sir, what Ms. Chaudhary was saying, there was one thing, sir. One argument in favor of Rahul Gandhi becoming Prime Minister is that as he's unmarried, maybe dynastic rule will make a finish. As to why the UPA government doesn't fall, is because nobody is sure of what the election will bring to him. The opposition party, one of the biggest opposition leaders, I met him the other day, one of the persons for whom I am very high regard, and you can guess who he is. I asked him, sir, what is your assessment of the current situation? Unhone kaha ki log is sarkar se khafa hai, magar humare se bhi nirash hai. That is why the people are not being enthused. You see, it is not enough to say Congress is doing something wrong. I must have the set of candidates whose character and record is such that everybody will believe that if we came to power, then things will really be different. Then they will flock. And that is what the opposition doesn't seem to realize. They think that because they can plant stories about themselves, or against their other rivals in the same political party, this having mass-based in 6 journalists, this is very many of the leaders in Delhi have, mass base of 6 journalists. And India is being run by them. Indian discourse is being run by them. So, that is the reason that the UPA too survives, flourishes, loots, evades, passes the buck, and no problem. Because there is no visible alternative which is completely of a different culture.
As a mother of 60 years, please tell me, how can I be of some help to this nation?
One, the first is of being a good mother. Nobody will bring up children and make adults who will have the values which all of us feel the country requires than the mother's will. Second, as a citizen, each of us can do things. Take up one issue, on that become the expert in the country. Take up one institution, a very small institution, like your resident welfare association. Improve that. Learn to use the new instruments which even such governments have had willy-nilly given to give us. For instance, the Right to Information Act. Learn to use it. And use it to pursue one office or one officer or one minister whom you regard as corrupt. Similarly, learn to use the new media, because the media today is a part of the problem. The established media, it's not a part of the solution. So learn to use. Now, for instance, this is a very good example we have today of a blog. It liberates us from the standard media. Each of us can do that and thereby spread the facts which are which Hanuman Chaudhary can recite at a moment's notice. So many things that we can do as individuals.
Here is a question about the media itself. Media apart from government is disintegrating the society. Not the country, it is disintegrating the society by meaningless pseudo secularism and 24-hour broadcast of reality. How a responsible citizen can control the media? National Broadcasting Association does not even bother to monitor. How do we change this?
It's very simple. Don't watch them in TV. Why do you watch them? I can't understand. Be like, at least in this matter, let us be like Gandhi. He did not read newspapers. He writes.
N.T. Ramarao also did not read anything.
But anyhow, Gandhiji did not. He said because in those days, newspapers actually focused on very big things. But Gandhiji said these are trivial passing things. So I am not going to spend time on it. Somebody will bring something to his attention. This is what so and so Times of India has reported. Then he will issue a clarification. So if we look at them and then say, well, they are disintegrating, they are superficial, they are just the same six fellows shouting at each other, it is a waste of time. Why look at them? You have the remote in your hand? Switch off.
Why is it that we always have a timid approach whenever we deal with the national integrity and security of our nation? If some people go on rampage in Bombay, saying Assamese get out or let him go out of the road, nobody bothers about it.
No, the reason for that is precisely that the candidates are elected from constituencies in which they depend on those 15%. So the nation's interests are never in their mind. What is the origin of secularism of the CPIM? The Muslim vote bank in West Bengal and in Kerala. And when you treat the Muslims as a bank, then naturally they also get a group identity. They realize that, no, this is my power. So it becomes a vicious circle. That is why the governments are timid and paralyzed. Because there will always be 20 MPs in any sir, as any Karna Ji. There will in fact be 20 ministers there who will not let you do it.
Thank you very much. I think we'll do the questions. Finally, Udit Raj, very recently, he's a leader of the Dalits. He has gone to Srikakulam and said, we want Dalitistan. And there is a map of Dalitistan, consisting of parts of Odisha, parts of Andhra Pradesh, parts of Jharkhand, parts of something, etc. In the year 2000, in the Economic and Political Weekly, which is a leftist weekly, Professor Amar Abbas has made out a case for Mughalistan. India should be divided again. Mughalistan created with the big parts of Bihar Uttar Pradesh, Uttar Pradesh, etc., and up to Pakistan. But he is late. Actually, Mr. T.V. Rajeshwar Rao, the head of IB, who became the governor of West Bengal, when he was the governor of West Bengal, wrote a report to the President of India that actually the third partition of India is imminent. And he gave a map and saying this is where already the population demographic balance has changed. And that included parts of Odisha, parts of Bihar, parts of Bengal, West Bengal and large part of Assam. And nothing happened. Therefore, when he retired as the governor, he then wrote those articles in the Hindustan Times, the Congress paper, and sent them to me. And you will find that account also in one of my books. But he said, Aranya Rodham, crying in the wilderness. So this gentleman who has now asked for the demand, he is only repeating, he is now concretizing the forecast of the head of IB, a person very loyal to this family and Congress and the governor of West Bengal.
Thank you, sir.